What's up, gamers? It's your boy, Launchpad 1412. Excited to be back with some Madden 16 gameplay. I got an online ranked match versus a random opponent. My opponent is Atlanta Falcons, and I have the Cleveland Browns. Like I said, I'm going up against the Cleveland Browns. And a lot of people have suggested, well, not a lot, but quite a few have suggested some Cleveland Browns gameplay. We're here to deliver that mail, knock down those pins. You guys know how I do. In the comment section right now, if we're going to play the Pacific team, let me know. I'll do the best I can to get to that team. Well, with that out of the way, second time I went against Atlanta Falcons, they got something that I don't know, man. Let me know in the comment section, man. Is there something special about the Falcons? I know they got Devontae Freeman, Matt Ryan at the helm, Julio Jones, Roddy White, Jacob Tamey. I know they got a pretty good arsenal of weapons on offense, so I know that's why I let people are picking Atlanta. I'm just playing around here a little bit as my opponent tried to convert the first down to 3rd and 8 and unsuccessful, and he ends up kicking a field goal on the 4th and 4, taking a 3-0 lead. It's my turn to burn and see what I can do, man. What I really wanted to do is hit this guy with a combination of runs as much as I possibly can. I know I don't have the best passing team, so I have to try to run the ball. I ran the ball 23 times, I believe 12 with Isaiah Crowell and 11 with Duke Johnson. Duke Johnson gets a nice toss right here, almost getting the first down. I'm sorry. So I'm coming down the field, trying to give him a little bit of this, a little bit of that as far as the running concern. I haven't passed the ball yet. I'm a little afraid to pass the ball because I know Johnny Manziel is not the best passer I've played with the Cleveland Browns before. And I've played with him like 2 or 3 times, and I think the 2 or 3 times I played with him, I won. Hopefully I can win this game. When Johnny Manziel, his throwing was not that good. I'm like, my God. I mean, this guy was throwing off, man. I don't know if he was throwing Jay Cutler off it, but I do get a nice run right here with Johnny Manziel for the first down on the 37, which was pretty huge for this drive. They're trying to come down here and get a score. But, yeah, some of his passes was just, it was just so off. Like I said, I don't know if it was Jay Cutler bad, but it was just, it was off, though. It was pretty off. They're going to toss it left right here and get the first score with the first touchdown of the contest, taking a 7-3 lead, man. Let's see what he got, man. This guy right here, he did a good job of mixing it up, man. Running the pass, running to the outside, running to the inside. It definitely was hard to tell what he was going to do next. I wasn't really sure. I know you've seen a lot of tosses right here early, but he didn't just do tosses to the outside. He did runs to the inside, too. So it's hard to kind of get a good grasp of how the opponent is playing when you're watching, opposed to actually playing the opponent. But I mean, he definitely did a good job mixing up. But look at the sack right there. Sent some heat right there. And it got there 2nd and 20. He drops back. And look at this, man. Julio Jones, man. This guy is a nightmare, man. This guy will give you a headache, man. No lie, man. This guy is such a beast, man. Toss it left right here on the 3rd and 7. Was shocked he did the toss on the 3rd and 7. But he ended up getting the first down. Next play, first down and goal. He tried to get into the touchdown with Devontae Freeman. He is successful. So he takes a 3-point lead right here, right before the half. I'm going to try to get a score here, see what I can do. I do a screen to the left right here that almost got picked up. But I ended up getting tackled on the backfield. Fucking gain some yards. 2nd and 12. I drop back. I go deep. And can I get the catch? No. He had it in his hands, though. And Johnny Manziel, he put it on him right there. So I said, okay. Ended up getting sacked right there. It's not Johnny Manziel's fault. And that in the half, of course, I'm not going to punt the ball right to him, so Devin Hester can do a run back for a touchdown. I lofted that ball as much as I possibly could on that. So we got halftime right here, and I'm feeling pretty good because I have stopped him. I haven't really shut him down, but I have stopped him, and I have forced him to kick a field goal. And, his offense has been pretty prolific, so I have to keep that in the back of my mind as I'm playing the game. And right here, I'm trying to take the lead. I get a nice run with Isaiah Crowell. And I'm trying to get some runs here with Duke Johnson. I just keep running the ball. And it's working. Thankfully for me, it's working. He has Atlanta Falcons team. They don't have the best defense. So I'm trying to take advantage of that as much as possible. If he was to shut down my run, I'm not really sure if I would even be in this game. I'm going to be honest with you, man. Johnny Manziel, his throwing is not, I don't want to say it's horrible, but it's bad enough for me to say that. 3rd down and 6. Check out this pass right here, man. Overthrows a wide open Travis Benjamin. But he ends up getting that catch in, though. So we end up getting that first down, so we'll take it, man. First down and goal right here. Not first down and goal, first down and 10, I'm sorry. We just try to get to the end zone. We're getting closer and closer. And at this moment, I'm a little shocked that I'm this close. Don't get me wrong, I have dig and dug my way down the field, running the ball and passing the ball, but this right here, I'm just a little shocked because it's usually harder for me to win with the Cleveland Browns. And a couple games that I've won with the Cleveland Browns, it was kind of the skin of my teeth to a degree, but I still won with them, man. I'm actually undefeated with them, believe it or not. I think it's a nice catch right there. I don't know what play that was, but that was a good play. I'm shocked he didn't run it again. But then again, the defense that I ran I guess that play was perfect for that play. So I see now. I kind of see why he didn't run it again. It's against the screen to the right here. I do not blame anything that he's doing with Devontae Freeman, man. I mean, you have to use this guy. This guy used Devontae Freeman in a proper way as far as just playing his game. I mean, hit him with some tosses, went on the inside a little bit to confuse the defense, and hit him with some screens. Like, you have to do this when you play with Atlanta Falcons, man. It's mandatory. At least the first 4-for-1 conversion right here. Cleveland defense not bad, but it's not great either. So, you know, sometimes they shut it down, sometimes they won't. So, first down and 10, I get a stop right there. Second down and 7, I get a stop right here. I'm putting the emphasis on this part of the drive for a reason. Third down and 5, I get that stop right there, and I force a 4th and inches. Can I stop Devontae Freeman? Yes, somehow right here. It looked like he got the first. I'm not going to lie. It looked like he got the first, but they said I stopped him, and I'll take it. He challenged it, and it still was my ball. I like, okay. I didn't blame him for the challenge. Why he doesn't have a timeout right there? I don't blame him for the challenge. I think it was a good challenge. 4th and 3. I felt like I had to go for this. I got to come down here and score. You know, there's a little over 2 minutes left. End of the game right here, 4th quarter. I got to come down here and get a score, man. Let's see if I can do that, man. Right here, check out this, man. Johnny Manziel puts this one right on the money. I hit Travis Benjamin for a huge game. I talking all that noise about Johnny, and he gets that catch. I was hyped about this one. I was like, yes. I thought the game was over, but it's not. Check out this, man. He gets a catch right here with Devin Hester. Next play. It doesn't hit me with the hair. I wanted to show you guys this on purpose and show you just to kind of give you a good feel for what he was doing. Right here, I throw it to the right here, and I believe that's Devontae Freeman he gets this. But check out this, man. This was my fault right here. This was my fault. I don't know how I could leave this guy one-on-one at this point, this juncture in the game. He catches it, Bogarts my cornerback, and there's a flip into the end zone. I deserve that. I'm going to be honest with y'all. I deserve that one. But check out this. Check out this decision right here. It's 2-point conversion. He drops back. He goes for the gold, and no, he doesn't get it. I was like, what the heck just happened? Honestly, he threw me off so much with 2-point conversion. I had to reconstruct some offense on the go. And I just picked a cover 3 or something, man. I didn't even know what to pick. I almost called a timeout. You know, he really threw me off right there. I just couldn't believe he did that, man. I got a question for you guys. Did he make the right call right there, though? Did he make the right call? I don't know if he did. I don't know if he didn't. In the comment section, let me know. Did he make the right call, man? Shout out to him. He played a really good game. You know, if he ties the ball game up and we go into overtime and he gets the ball, you know, I kind of think maybe he wins this game. I'm going to be honest with you. In the game, maybe I stopped him. Who knows, man? I would say we were pretty even, man. Dude probably was a lot sharper than what he displayed in this game, man. But shout out to him, man. Much love, much respect. But we'll take the win. We'll take the 1-point victory. Winning by the skin of my teeth again with the Cleveland Browns. I mean, it's probably going to be like that when you play with a team like the Browns. It's just, it's kind of inevitable. You know, it's kind of inevitable, man. This is your boy, Lance Pratt, 1412. Hope you guys enjoyed the vid. And I'm out.